I would like to present you some of my projects very quickly because there are many. So we start from the Temporary Autonomous Museum for All, TAMA. TAMA in Greek means offering, but also the promise of an offering to a saint in return from his or her help, a vow. This is the meaning of TAMA. So I'll try to show you how I find out, I mean, a small community, hidden Gypsy community or Roma community in the suburb of Athens. TAMA is located in Avliza, a rundown area in western Athens, 10 kilometers from the center of the capital and very close to the new Olympi village. Itinerary populations such as Gypsies and Vlach Romanians from north of Greece use this area as a pied-à-terre. My discovery of the place was accidental, but my involvement in its life was intentional, and it came as a natural sequence of my attitude as an artist in 1998. I visited the place for the first time, as I told you, in 1998, with my friends Katerina and Michelle, looking for old furnitures at good prices. But when I found myself there, it was not the antiques that attached me, but the place itself. I'll show you some of the first images I saw there. Things like that. Unexpected events, strange images, unplanned artworks, strange people. What I saw there is the concept of a makeshift settlement, a kind of mobile post-urban city which serves its inhabitants' temporary housing needs and economic activities. Everything forms part of this small town. Landscape, clothes, interiors, unfinished buildings, streets, cars, the sky, the people. I started to visit Avliza every day. I became an addicted visitor. The observation of the place and people became my foremost duty. I wanted to become friends with them, to participate in their fiestas, to share their problems, to listen to their thoughts and needs. After a long try, I had it, and a strong relationship started. The nomadic way of living and the particularities of the community gave me the idea of setting up a system of communication and exchange among the inhabitants, myself, the art people, and the public. In a very short time, I realized that all my friends and associates wanted to participate in this story, which I call a temporary autonomous museum for all. So I have a book here. It's for you, for the center. And very quickly, I'm going to show you how the place was. At the beginning, my idea was to make a fake museum when I visit the place, the area for the first time. I said, look, we don't have a museum of contemporary art in Greece, but art is everywhere. So I found here a Thomas Hirschhorn, here Damien Hirst, you know, Thomas Schutte. I remember the work of Thomas Schutte during Documenta in 1992 at Fridericianum. Yes, it's quite the same. Okay. Vanessa Beecroft, her first show at Sotheby's in Amsterdam, The Wall in 1992. Kounelis, and some other artists. So I went home and I said, oh, we don't have a museum of contemporary art in Athens, but art is everywhere. So I'm gonna found the museum. And then I said, it's idiotic. Okay, this is the first approach. It's, you know, an irony to the Greek society, art society. But the people there are so important. So I started to go back again in order to establish a good relationship with them. And with them, we decided to found the Temporary Autonomous Museum for All as a Trojan horse in order to get what is missing from the government. So I became the mediator between the community and the governments. And we succeeded to have a lot of, how we say, infrastructures in the place, of course. And but when the Olympic Games came to Greece, everything was destroyed again, anyway. I'm working with the Roma people or gypsies in Greece up to now. It is an ongoing project. We have done together a lot of interventions in the city, a lot of performance. We have built a lot of artworks together. And our latest collaboration is the Firma Gypsy Globales. It is a fashion firma. And this is the book about our fashion. We did it together. So this is also for you. So the book, the Tama book, is divided in four sections. The first is the temporary, so we have images of the space.
It's 12 hours.
Thank you. The other, okay, it is every 1 hour, so I will be finished by, yes. Okay, so the second part, the A, is autonomous, and we have photos from the space. The third part, M, is the museum, and it is all the ideas about the infrastructure of the place, because with my architects, we organize, and of course, the inhabitants of the place, we organize their public space. And the last part, and also we have the prototype of a house. And the last part is for all, and we have the contributions from other artists up to 2002, because at 2002 I present this project for the first time at the São Paulo Biennial. So this is Tama. There are a lot of contributions from different people, from lawyers, architects, filmmakers, artists, art historians, musicians, and so on. So this is the book. Let's go now. Where are we going now? Let's go now to another project. No, before this, it is another project. We call it Frihot. Do you like to see a small video, which is the participation of the artist Fabiana De Barros at the Tama project? Okay, we had the idea. I had the idea to invite Fabiana De Barros because we've been together in a show in Geneva in 2000 about playgrounds for refugee kids. So she presented a model of a kiosk, very nice kiosk. So I had the idea that if I build this kiosk in the community there, we can have it's possible to have a nice gathering point for many activities. So I invited Fabiana to build her kiosk at Avliza.
Thank you.
okay, we go to the area, and because, you know, it's a long story, so. And we use this kiosk some like 4 years for different activities. It was a kind of playground for the kids, a meeting point for the ladies. We work a lot with lawyers and doctors. And at the end, in 2004, I think, the winter was very cold. So the people, they had to burn the kiosk. So it was normal, I mean. Okay. Another project that I'm doing is the free hotels. The free hotel project. Let's see. I need two. Okay. So here you have the map of Europe and Middle East. I have done a hotel, the Plug-in Hotel in Canaria, Hotel Isola in Milan, Cosmotel in Skopje, Hotel International in Greece, and Hotel Grande in Greece, Hotel Nokul in Turkey, and Hotel Balkan in Israel. I wrote some sentences this morning about my hotels. Where are they? Here. So, my hotels are places of hospitality in the age of precarity. Free hotels are about travel, travelers, dwelling, xenia, hospitality, community, time, alien, identity, and participation. Here is another book. The book starts with an interview between me and Yorgos Tzirtzilakis. It's about hospitality and the history of my family, because my grandfather was a hotel owner, my father and my mother as well, and I work also in hotels before some years ago. I didn't know if I would like to become an artist or not. I mean, I was not sure. But at the age of 35, I decided, yes, this is what I have to do. But before that, I used to be hotel owner. Okay, here we have an interview. And we have images for all my hotels. All of them are mostly one reception and one room, double room. It's for the travelers of the cities. The travelers of the cities, they need also a stop to rethink, to relax. The cities in south are a little bit different from the cities in north, because how we built the cities in south, it was at a church, and then all around we used to build the houses, so the city is in circles. In north, the new cities are like, a canvas. So you don't have a lot of things to discover. If you can see the street from here and to the end, I mean, you know exactly what you expect to see. But if you are in an old south city and you have to go around, you don't know what you will find out in the next corner. So it's tiring. And I decided to give the opportunity to the people to have a rest and think about. So in the reception, I have a kind of a guide from the city, but the city is pointed by me. I mean, whatever is important for me, this period about in every place I have my hotel. This is the first hotel in Greece, and here you can see the restaurant. This hotel had a restaurant, I mean, just for the opening of the show. Okay, so I don't like to eat your time with my hotels, although they are really good. I had also this one in an island, in Andros Island, during the first Andros International Show. This is a tent from Lidl. Also, we have two spaces, the entrance and the space to sleep. That was really nice. I mean, the tourists, they had a place to stay, but at the end of the summer, went by with the wind, and is okay. And some other hotels, so there is a site on internet, you can go there and check it. I don't like to say more. And let's go to Susie Trot. I forgot to tell you that the last 7 years, I'm trying to publish a book. La Poverina editor is Pellin Tan, and this is gonna be the cover of the book. This is the cover of the book. The title is Situations, Coexistences, Commons. We start to work on this book 7 years ago, but because I'm working all the time and I have a new project, we say, let's put this project. So last week we decided that we don't add any more project because we need to, I mean, the book must be published. The publisher is DPR Barcelona, and I may show you here the. Why I can't open this? No, it's open here. No. I would like to show you the chapters, but I can't. Here are the chapters. Okay, the book is divided in, yes, one, two, three, four, five, six subject, self in other, dialogues, in situ, common, core, and dissemination. So I hope that you're gonna get it in October. Okay, I will send it to you. Okay. And now let's go to Susie Tross. Susie Tross is this. Susie Tross is an art canteen. My family owns this place. And during crisis, the place was empty at the beginning of the crisis, 2011. It was a service for this kind of machines. This, I don't know the name, platform, I don't know the name of this. Okay, so the owners, they didn't pay the rent. We throw them out. And I sold all the leftovers I found inside, a lot of metal things, etc. And with the money of the leftovers, I restore the courtyard because we have three rooms and a courtyard in the middle. I put the sign, Susie Tross, Loveless, Hot Rahanas, Air Condition, No Vacancy. And I open the art canteen. So at Susie Tross, our aim is to weave together the city of Athens and its inhabitants into a vibrant, multicolor network through an open embrace of its diverse communities by organizing art-based project events, gathering, and workshops. So, Susie Tross' name comes from a mainstream comedy filmed in 1969 during the dictatorship in Athens, where the low class, people from the low class, started to have a lot of money, and all the intellectual and the lefties were in the prisons. So these people, instead to invest money to education or whatever, they started to eat. to eat a lot. And just a minute. I would like to go back here to show you. To show you a small part of this film to understand what means Suzy draws. Means Suzy you eat. So, from this film, I had the idea to give the name Suzy Tros to Suzy Tros. There is also a page, we have a page on Facebook. You can go there and see many other activities that we have done and videos about all our big events. And when Suzy Tros is invited to other places, like, let's say, we were invited at the Adhocracy show at Onassis Foundation in Athens, so it becomes Suzy Tros Embassy. And we create gathering places in between the shows, because the people, they have to, I mean, the visitors, they have to be together to have a small lunch, something, okay. In order to see the space, I would like to show you our first, just our first activity by the title Tear and Repair. We ask everybody for our first event to come to the space with a chair, and this was the poster. And we tear and repair just to calm our nerves, how we say. Okay, this is another. Okay. So if you like, you may go to the Susie Tross page on Facebook and like it, of course. And also you may go to the Victoria Square project on Facebook. We have all our activities there. Now we organize the website. But yes, you can see many things. Okay, what is going on with the Victoria Square project? As you know, I'm not a document artist, but this is not a problem. If you like to do your job, you can do it even if you are not part of a big show. Rick Lowe was invited by Documenta to create a project in Greece. He went to different places in Athens and he decided to work at Victoria Square because Victoria Square is one of our historical neighborhoods with a lot of different, diverse people now, Greeks, non-Greeks, immigrants, refugees, etc. There are a lot of conflicts in the area. So that's why Rick decided to chosen this area in order to establish his project. For the first time that he came in Greece, because we had a lot of common friends, artists, he wanted to meet me, we met, and we decided to work together. So we share the project, it is our project. And this project will stay minimum up to April 2018. Because if we, when you work with people, it's not possible to do it just for 3 months. It's idiotic. Because what you have to do is to establish relations, is to establish trust, is to make the people to open up. And to see how they can work and live together, and also to know each other. So you need a lot of involvement. You must be dedicated to this aim, and you need time. So Rika and I, we decided to have the project minimum up to April 2018. So this project goes out of Documenta, has his own identity, so we can share it. And our main tool is this newspaper. If you go to the Facebook page, you can have all the newspapers there. We call it one-to-one, and it was the way to connect all the businesses of the area. In the front page, we have the shops inside. We have the portraits of the owners, and they have to reply just to 2 questions. When did you first open your business in Victoria Square neighborhood, and how you describe Victoria Square? So up to now, yesterday or 2 days ago, we had the 14th issue, and here we have the map and it indicates where the businesses are, so everybody can visit. Also, we have the game because it's a newspaper. All the newspapers, they have some like that. And this is a way, this is a very good way because like this, we put all the businesses together and our place, which is a very nice shop in a corner, in a small street near the area, is the meeting point, not only for the businesses, but also for young guys, for immigrant groups, for refugees groups. I mean, we work with all the different inhabitants of the area, and we do a lot of artistic projects there, and we try to teach the people how to, let's say, in a way, how to express themselves, but also we give the tool, you know, if they would like to get some money, they can find out many ways there, because we teach silk screen, we teach dance, we teach photography. I mean, we do a lot of different diverse projects. So that's it. I don't have time anymore. It's over. So I say goodbye, thank you very much. I shut down my computer and I'm going.